All right, the NBA's best remaining head coaches that are free agents in the market. Let's kind of cover these and we can kind of play along with this. But number one, Doc Rivers. As of yesterday, the Philadelphia 76ers offered him a 5-year contract. He signed it and he's now going to be the new head coach of the Philadelphia 76ers. My initial thoughts, it's an okay signing. How I kind of seen the Philadelphia 76ers, and I made videos and posted, yada, yada, yada. I've always wanted Ben Simmons to not run the point guard position anymore. I think he needs to take on the point forward position. So move him down to the 3 or the 4. I think internally they need to make roster changes. With Elton Brand, he needs to get Tobias Harris out of there with that contract. Same thing with Al Horford. But that team needs an offensive-minded, coordinated head coach to start with. Preferably, I wanted Mike D'Antoni or Kenn Atkinson for the Philadelphia 76ers. I think there's a lot of great tools, a lot of great players on the team, but it's just a wrong formula. So with Brett Brown, he didn't know how to orchestrate that team together. Elton Brand needs to put a bunch of snipers and cheaters out there to fit alongside Joel Embiid and Ben Simmons. Now with Doc Rivers, that's going to be, you know, the new head coach for them. Doc Rivers has always had teams with the Tracy McGrady Orlando Magic, with the Big 3 Boston Celtics, and the two different areas for the Clippers, the CP3 Blake Griffin, DeAndre Jordan, and then the Paul George and Kawhi Leonard. He's always had star players. So with Doc Rivers, there was talks of him either looking at the Rockets or the Sixers. It makes sense to not go to the Rockets because James Harden and Russell Westbrook are too high maintenance. They're getting older. And their winning era pretty much has ended. But the 76ers, they're very young in age. And I can actually see Joel Embiid and Doc Rivers work together. Ben Simmons may be a little tougher, but Simmons needs to be more of a scorer, not a facilitator. And he needs to shoot more from the offense. So I really hope Doc Rivers can get on that groove and he can be able to pretty much, you know, get on these guys and these cats. But since Doc Rivers is the head coach, the Sixers really need to find some offensive coordinators and some assistant coaches to work and game plan on the offensive side. Because Doc Rivers usually likes to rely heavily on his offensive stars, kind of like street ball. But I think he'll be fine with the Sixers. Next is Mike D'Antoni. Like I said before, I thought preferably the Sixers would have been a great fit for him. Besides from that, I actually have him with the New Orleans Pelicans. I think with a young, energetic college-type team like the Pelicans with Alonzo, Brandon Ingram, and Zion Williamson, they like to run. They're young. They're energetic. I think the 7 seconds and less offense can work very well with this team. He's probably going to have to throw Zion Williamson to the 5. He's Jackson Hayes. He's not going to... Mike D'Antoni likes to run small. And with Jackson Hayes, who's very young and he needs to build more muscle, he doesn't have it yet. I would really see Mike D'Antoni putting Zion Williamson at the 5. Maybe Brandon Ingram at the 4. You're going to need another wing and another 3-and-D type player to fit in. But with Lonzo Ball, that's going to be a big start and a big case for that team. He needs to be able to shoot from the outside and needs to work everything alongside there. So Mike D'Antoni, I could see him most definitely with the New Orleans Pelicans to sign with. It kind of leaves Alvin Gentry. He got fired by the Pelicans. I don't see him truly to be on a head coaching position for any team. I see when it comes to Alvin Gentry that pretty much in the basics that he will just have to go to an assistant coach. You'll probably have to be an assistant coach for a team. It kind of leads into Nate McMillan as well. Now, I could see some teams probably like the Oklahoma City Thunder, kind of small teams like that. They can probably give a year and a year and a half on Nate McMillan or Alvin Gentry, but I don't see too much for those cats. Next one, Greg Popovich. He's still the head coach for the San Antonio Spurs. I think probably for this position for him that he may retire. I think it's the best case. His team hasn't been a contender the last 2-3 years, and after losing Kawhi Leonard, it's been pretty much down the drain of championship contention status when it's come down to it. So for the Spurs, we could probably see either Tim Duncan come from an assistant coach to a head coach position on that team. There's always been talks of Becky Hammon. I don't want to hear none of that nonsense, so kind of jump in from there. Brett Brown with the Philadelphia 76ers. He was on that organization and franchise for the last 5 or 6 seasons or so. I truly don't see Brett Brown jump into a head coach position. I think he'd be more ideally for an assistant coach. Now, I don't know where. It doesn't really matter too much for me, but it is what it is. Oh, also with Alvin Gentry, he will probably most likely be an assistant coach to join Doc Rivers in the 76ers. Next one, Billy Donovan. He was a free agent for a hot minute, but then the Chicago Bulls did pick him up. So kudos to him. I don't see too much with that signing, whatsoever when it comes down to it. Chicago, they have a lot of internal problems. They need to make some roster changes, but adding Billy Donovan, very overrated pick. I don't care for it, but Chicago, that whole franchise, they're a mess. Who we got next? Yeah, they fired John Bellion. I doubt he'll get back into the NBA ever. The Minnesota Timberwolves, you've had Ryan Saunders. They'll probably keep him for another year or so. But with the Karl-Anthony Towns, who's very desperate to leave based on trade rumors, we'll kind of see what happens there. Let's see, the Wizards, you have Scott Brooks. They're probably going to keep him for one last season with John Wall and Bradley Beal. The New York Knicks picked up Tom Thibodeau. So I don't like the pick. I don't like the fit at all whatsoever. But, you know, him with a bunch of young cats, he's just going to have to run them. RJ Barrett, 45 minutes a game in the high 40s, so it's whatever. Who we got? Kenny Atkinson. So Kenny Atkinson, I really like that coach as he built up the Brooklyn Nets. And like I said before, I would have liked Kenny Atkinson to sign with the Philadelphia 76ers, but that's not the case anymore when it comes down to him. I think when it comes to Kenny Atkinson, he needs to be on a young team that he can build with. Offensively, I think it could make sense with the Houston Rockets, but James Harden does not like to be coached, and James Harden wants the ball always in his hand, so I can't see Kenny Atkinson being on there with them. Trying to think real quick would be a good fit for him. I think the Minnesota Timberwolves, if you're going to let go of Ryan Saunders, go for Kenny Atkinson on that team. I wanted Kenny Atkinson also to be on the Chicago Bulls, but the Bulls already jumped the gun when it came to them. If you're the Pelicans, either go for Mike D'Antoni or Kenny Atkinson. That's how I say in my position on that part. Tyronn Lue. I think based on what everything's kind of pointing to, I think the Clippers are probably going to go with Tyronn Lue for them to sign on their team. You could put Sam Cassell as well, but Ty Lue already has head coach experience and he has a championship ring, so I just think that's the way they're probably going to go with it. I don't see any other head coach that can fit as well as with the Los Angeles Clippers. And let's see next. Mike Budenholzer is going to stay with the Bucks. A lot of cats throw out the name Mark Jackson for the last 4 to 5 seasons. I don't want to hear that anymore. He's always going to be staying with Jeff Van Gundy and Mike Breen on the set, so nothing on that part. But besides from there, not too many head coaches that we've seen. Now, we've seen basically the Brooklyn Nets with Steve Nash. They kind of, you know, went out of nowhere with that one. And Kyrie Irving pretty much stated that they don't really need a head coach, and it's not going to be the way. So kind of curious how that goes for them. But overall, things are looking how it is. We could see some firings this offseason with like Dwayne Casey with the Pistons. Maybe I doubt Terry Stotts ever gets fired with the Portland Trail Blazers, but yeah, next steps is just kind of seeing Mike D'Antoni and go from there.